Other key initiatives in the department under the office of the mayor include marketing and communication to ensure that Joburg is well positioned as a leading economic hub in Africa. It further includes smart city initiatives to establish integrated disaster management center and broadband base stations. Furthermore, the department and the units will be intensifying all the water-based plans intervention. Portion of the budget going towards finance charges to service bonds and loans as part of the overall funding model of the city's capital investment program. Other programs that will be funded by the department are aligned to the financial development plan, which aims to ensure continued financial sustainability of the city. Group Corporate and Shared Services, Councillor Osmane, receives an operating budget of 834 million for the 2014-15 financial year and a 3-year capital budget of 1.6 billion for various projects. Key projects include ICT infrastructure renewal and optimization, the upgrade of software in the city, broadband migration citywide, and ongoing procurement of new fleet. Madam Speaker, the Office of the Speaker and the Legislature is allocated a budget of a budget of 281 million rand. A multi-year capital budget of 103 million goes mainly towards the renewal of the council chamber in the medium term. This follows a feasibility study undertaken in the current financial year. Madam Speaker, tariff setting is pivotal and strategic part of compilation of any budget. The city annually reviews its tariff to ascertain whether they are still capable of producing the required revenue envelope, taking note of the prevailing trends. This process of tariff setting takes place within a framework of the city's tariff policy. The tariff policy is based on the principles of financial sustainability and social considerations, as it relates to affordability of services, economic soundness, and environmental considerations. Madam Speaker, given the challenges we've noted on the prioritization of payment for municipal services, I therefore appeal to the residents of Johannesburg to prioritize payments for services as we partner together in developing this great city, Johannesburg. In setting the tariffs, the city also has to balance the tensions around affordability, economic conditions, input costs, whilst also ensuring that tariffs are cost reflective, especially for the trading services such as water, sanitation, electricity, and refuse removal. Tariffs for these services are informed by bulk purchases rather than inflation. The percentage increases from both Eskom and Rainwater are above the South African Reserve Bank inflation target range. Given that these tariff increases are determined by external agencies, the impact they have on the municipality's electricity and water tariff is largely outside the control of the city. Tariffs are further set with a view of striking a balance between a wide spectrum of households in Johannesburg and taking particular note of the interest of the poor. Furthermore, tariffs are also set cognizant of the impact of remaining competitive and attracting investment into the city. It is within this context that the tariff increases for 2014-15 financial year are proposed. Property rates fund approximately 40% of cost of services in the city. These include road infrastructure, parks, zoo, health, transportation, public safety, as well as other community-related services. Determining the appropriate property rate tariff is therefore a crucial part of the city's budgeting process. Madam Speaker, the property rate tariff increase is only 5% for the 2014-15 financial year. However, we need to highlight the following stipulations on the property rates policy. In responding to the input from business, the city will be reducing the ratio between residential and business from 1:3 to 1:2.8. So there's been a reduction of 0.2 points on the business tariff. Furthermore, the pensioners, Councillor Mendelssohn, Councillor Brookman Richards, the pensioners whose property values are less than 2 million and their household incomes of less than 7,000 rands, it's up from 6,000 last year, will be given 100% rebate. Pensioners whose income is higher than 7,000 and less than 12,000, Councillor Naidu, up from 11,000 last year, qualify for a 50% rebate. The residential sectional title rebate has been dropped, Executive Mayor, from 15% to 10%. Other rebates include 100% rebates are given to organizations responsible for animal protection. 20% rebate for heritage sites.